I've got a really cool JSON sample to show you, and this one is perfect for beginners. Not only is this easy to create, it requires very little JSON, but also teaches a few crucial points about what things are there in JSON to allow you to create really cool solutions. So let's jump into this thing and see how it works, and I'll give you some pointers along the way. So I've got a work progress tracker list here on my team site. Now this is just a standard list that you can create just by clicking on new and list, and you'll see work progress tracker here. It also has actually a flow that goes with it to remind people when they are when items are becoming due. So it's kind of a cool template. It's a good starting point if you want something like this. But what it does allow me to do is get an assigned to field, because this JSON solution is going to be using a people picker, a people field. So I've already got this list created. I've got it filled out with data and assigned to various people in my organization. Now, you'll see that every name in here that is not me, Steve Corey, is just going to be, you know, normal text. But we get down to me, and now we see that there's some color to it. There's some boldness to it. It stands out more. So that's really what this solution does, is it makes the text kind of pop out. If it's for you, the user, whoever's viewing this, they'll see this type of experience. But before we go into the other aspects of what this can do and how powerful this simple solution is, let's just erase all this and let's start from scratch to see how this whole formatting thing is set up. I'm just going to go into column settings and format, and we're going to switch to design mode, which will blow all of this away, get us right back to a stock experience here for this people field. So let's look at the solution right now. This solution comes from the PNP repository, part of the M365 and Power Platform community. It was created by Chris Kent. If you haven't heard of him and you're into JSON formatting, you ought to look him up. He is definitely one of the legends out there. It's a really simple solution. It's really one JSON file, although he gives you two of them, because he gives you not only the format that I use, just the expression, like Excel style expressions is what I would call it, but he also gives you the abstract syntax tree method of doing this, which looks a little bit different. If you've done any CAML queries with SharePoint views or some other similar technologies, I think some of the REST APIs will use CAML queries as well. This looked a little bit similar to that. It's a lot more broken out, possibly easier to read depending on how your brain works. My brain doesn't really work that well with this. It's a little harder for me to understand versus an expression, just a simple expression like you would see in Excel. But what I want to do is I want to grab this JSON right here, and I could highlight and hit Control C, or actually there's a copy raw file button right here. So I could just click this. It's copied into my clipboard. And all I have to do now is go into my list. But first, let's just double check what this thing needs. The view requirement, this says it can be applied to any person column. So as long as you've got a person column, this will work. Now, I would think this is going to apply to a single valued person column. But if you look down here at the bottom, you'll see that there is a similar example that will work with a multi-person field. So if you need that, there's an option right down here. But we've got our JSON copied. Let's jump into here, and we're going to format this column and apply our formatter. So once we're into this formatting section, we go down to advanced mode. And then here is just the starting schema. Schema is just the rule set that we have to play by with JSON formatting. We're going to erase that, and we're going to paste in our JSON. Now we can scoot this window out a little bit to take a look at what's in here, but we can also hit preview to see what this looks like. And we instantly get this solution. We get the result that we were looking for. This is what this JSON formatter does. But let's look at how this thing actually works. It's extremely simple, as I said. It uses one div, so one HTML tag, to display the name. And we see that right here with element type, it's creating a div. The text content is getting set to the current field, which would be our person column. And then the title field of that field, the title value, which in this case is going to be the name of that user. whether it's Nestor Wilkie or Steve Corey. But that really just displays the name. We needed to do something special when it's the current user who's viewing that particular list. And that's where this attributes thing comes in. So this is going to let us specify some additional properties for the HTML field, such as the class. Now, what we're really doing here is we're applying some CSS rules to format this, but we don't want to just specify the font color, the font weight, which is really what we're doing, because that's going to hard code it to really a particular value. What we can do instead is we can leverage some of the styles that come with SharePoint, specifically the ones that deal with the themes. Now, if you look at this, we are using an expression. Let's go to the expression first, kind of break this down. We're using an if statement. So we're going to compare two values. If they're equal, we're going to use the second part of this expression. If they're not equal, then we're going to use the third part. But in this case, we're comparing the @ and me. Now, this is a special string in JSON formatting that will resolve to the current user. Me, since I'm on that site. If you're on that site, it would resolve to you. And specifically, it will resolve to your email address. So we're comparing @me to @currentField, another special string, which, as you can tell, resolves to the current field that we're on. And then the email address, because in this case, current field is an object. It's going to be the user object, and it'll have things like title that we've already used, but it'll also have the email address. So we're comparing those two together, which will be just two email addresses. And if they're the same values, then we know that this particular row, whether that's Nestor or myself, that's the same person as the person viewing this. So if this is my record that I'm seeing right here, then we're going to set the class attribute, which is a CSS class, to MS font color theme primary. So this will set it to the primary theme color, regardless of what the theme color is. And it's going to also set the font weight to semi-bold. It's going to do both of those things if I'm viewing my own records. And you can tell that it's adding both because there's just a simple space in between these two. Now, if it's not my records that are being rendered for me, like Nestor right above my name, you'll see the Nestor records. If it's those records that SharePoint's actually putting out of the screen, then it just sets class equal to a blank string. So it does nothing, which is evident because that's what we see here. So if it's rendering the records for me, I get it bold and I get it in the theme color. Otherwise, it's just plain old text, nothing special at all, so that it doesn't stand out. So this is a really neat way to make that text pop out so it grabs my attention. But we're obviously missing some things here. I'm gonna click save so we can kind of get this out of the way. Now, this is a really, really simple example. This is just doing a div and just adding text. Now, obviously, when we started with this, we had the image, we had the profile image. You can add that back. This, like I said, this is the starting point. So you can add the profile picture back. You can do any number of things once you've got this starting point. I'm going to show you how the theme works with this. But before we do, if this is something that you're interested in, if you like what you can do with JSON formatting without having to learn things like JavaScript, TypeScript, any of that kind of mess, you're going to want to check out my JSON course where I teach you how all this works, what JSON even is, what formatting is, how they're applied to create really cool solutions, whether it's basic ones like this or really complex ones that can fire off Power Automate flows or send messages in Teams. There's a lot of things that are possible. You start with something really simple like this, and then you just build it out as you go, testing along the way. I've got a really, really good system that I use to teach people so that they're not taking on too much at once. That's my opinion. That's what the students seem to feel as well. So if you're interested, check the description below and you'll see a link where you can find more information about this course. But let's try out this theme. Let's see what happens if we change the theme around. So right now we're just using like a standard teal looking theme. Let's change the look here. And let's go to something totally different. How about like a dark yellow? And see, look, the primary theme, because we're referencing that primary theme in our JSON formatting, now instead of like a bluish, tealish kind of color, now it's a yellow color. It stands out and it matches the site theme. See all of our text up here? Well, the icons are yellow. The new button is yellow. The little indicator showing the item was created recently, that is yellow. So it matches the theme color really well. And so you can check this out. Whatever you set that theme to, it's going to match the look of that. And that's one of the really cool things about using these special classes that Microsoft provides as part of SharePoint. You can leverage that to make your formatting look like it was part of the site to begin with. It all just blends together. Now, if you want to find more information about this formatter, again, links are in the description below, whether it's to my course or this particular solution. And if you want to find more JSON formatting solutions, I've got other videos just like this going over more technical, more complex solutions, and just kind of break a lot of the stuff down for you. So don't forget to check that one out, including this one right here, which I really think is cool. And you ought to check this out. It's the employee praise cards. One of my favorite samples to show to people. And check that out. I will see you over there.